A very good morning to all of you and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. This is Rajiv and today we are going to make this horse animation in PowerPoint 2016. And before we dig into this tutorial, let me tell you that if you have not watched my previous video on how to create landscape parallel effects and how to use flash funds animation in PowerPoint 2016, then you should must watch these tutorials first and then you should try this animation in PowerPoint 2016 or 2019. Even you can create this animation in earlier versions of PowerPoint as well. So let's get started, and before we do that, let me tell you that this animation is inspired from one of the animation by Fitosa at dribble.com. The trees are inspired from this animation and you can have a look of trees right here at behance.net. Same profile of Fitosa is also here and you can see that how he have drawn these trees. And I replicated these trees using the shape tools in PowerPoint 2016. So I only used 2 or 3 trees from here. And another one is from Stevie at dribble.com. The horse is inspired from this animation. And let's get started. And before that, I will show you all the objects that I have drawn using the shape tool. And for that, I will go to the home tab and click the select drop-down button and open selection pan. And here you can see the list of objects that I have used. And you don't need to worry to see this huge list of objects. So let me also show you the animations that I have applied on this presentation by opening the animations pane from the animations tab. And here is the list of the animations. So let me show you the slideshow first and then we will talk about all these objects and the animations that I have applied. So here is the slideshow. And if you look carefully, then you can notice that the background trees are similar and I have drawn just one tree and then just replicated it as many times I want. And I did the same for all the trees. I draw one tree and then replicated the same. So we only have 3 tree layers in this animation. And for horses, as you can see here, we only animated one horse, then replicated and reduced the size. So you don't need to worry about these many objects and these many of animations in this presentation. So I will start from the beginning, and for that what I will do, I will select this tree layer, we'll make a copy of it and we'll paste it into the new slide. So you can look into the animations and the objects. I will zoom out. So as you can see that only one tree has been drawn and then I replicated the same tree and make a group of them. And if I now open the animation span, then you can see that which animation I have applied. I have applied the left motion path with a duration timing of 6 seconds. It is repeating itself again and again until the slides end. And if I select show you the motion path length, then you can notice that the length is up to right here. So when you need to make a motion or when you need to make a loop of these kinds of motion like moving tree over the slide, then the ending position should must match with the object that you are seeing on the slide. So if you are seeing one tree, then the ending position of the motion path exactly match with the object on the screen. So when you will see the slideshow as it has a loop until end of the slide, you can see that from the timings tab until end of the slide, duration is 6 seconds. So when you will see the slideshow, then this tree will not make any kind of flicker during the loop. It will repeat itself until end of the slide without making any glitches between the loops. So I use the same technique for all the trees here. As you can see this one, let me copy this one and paste it on the new slide. So I draw one of the tree and replicated it many times and then applied the same left motion path with lesser duration. So the tree which are on front will move faster. As you can see, the tree on front are moving faster and tree are which are behind are moving at less speed. So that will create a landscape parallel effects, and you can watch my video on that, how to create landscape parallel effects in PowerPoint, to get more information about it. Now let's talk about the horse. So here we have this horse. Let me copy this one, all the layers of this horse, and then paste them into a new slide. And let me delete these trees, paste it right here and zoom in. So we have applied two animations to these layers of horses. As you can see here, 10 motion paths and 10 flash ones animation effect. So if I open the selection pane, then you can see that for horse animation, I am using 10 different layers. Let me collapse all of these, and PowerPoint doesn't have any option to expand all or collapse all the layers in the selection pane. So here I show you the horse, and as you can see, these horses have different position in each frame. So I am using 10 different frames for one horse to make it animate. So if I show you slideshow now, then you can see all the 10 frames moving to the right. Select one of the horse, go to the shape format tab, click the group drop down button and choose ungroup, zoom in a little bit. And here you can see all the layers that I have used to create a single horse. So what I did, I used the shape tool, freeform shape, to draw this horse along with the rounded corner rectangle. This one, rounded corner rectangle and freeform shape. So after drawing one of the horse, for the next pose or next frame, what I did, I replicated the same frame by selecting all of them and holding the control shift keys while dragging and dropping to make a duplicate. Or you can also press control D after selecting all the objects to make a replication. Or you can also use copy and paste command. For the next frame, what you can do, let's say you can select this tail here and go to the shape format tab, click the edit shape drop down button and then choose edit points. And then you can select one of these points and can change the shape as you want. So I use the same technique to create 10 different poses of the same horse, as you can see here. And then I applied the flash ones animation on them. And you can watch my tutorial on how to use flash ones animation in PowerPoint 2016 or 2019. So let me give you a quick overview that how you can use the flash ones animation effect in PowerPoint 2016 or 2019. And for that, you need to download my presentation and open it. And then let's say you have an object on which you want to apply the flash ones animation. So after opening my presentation, you can select one of the horse having the flash ones animation effect. As you can see, I have selected the last layer, frame 10, and then click the animation painter once and then click on the object on which you want to apply the flash ones. And that way it can replicate the flash ones animation because it is not available in the later versions of PowerPoint than 2007. So once you have the flash ones animation effect inside your presentation, then you can select your object and then click on the animation painter and then click on the next object on which you want to apply the flash ones. So that is the way you can have flash ones inside your presentation. So I will close this presentation and will show you that how I applied the flash ones to the horses. So I will select this one, make a copy, and inside the new presentation, I will paste them. And we'll change the layout to black. So as you can see here, if I open the animation span, then you can see that we have 10 flash ones animation applied on each layer of the horse. If I open the selection pane, then you can see that there are 10 different layers of the horse. And each one of them, we applied the flash ones animation. And what are the duration and delay timing? For the duration, I am using 0.80 seconds for all the frames. And for the delay timing from the very second frame, I am using a delay timing of 0.08 seconds. And for the third frame, 0.16. And for the fourth frame, 0.24 and so on. So I am adding, I am adding 0.08 further delay timing between each of the frame. And I am also applying the right motion path. And I have also applied the right motion path to the horses. And if you see the slideshow, then it will look like this. So once you have all the layers of an object on which you want to apply the flash ones animation, one thing you should notice that you should select all of these same layers and go to the shape format tab, click the align drop down button and click align center and then align middle. to make an exact position of all the layers on the slide. So when all the layers will play simultaneously, then there will no glitch between the animation. So once you have done this, to make more replications of this horse and to reduce the size, what you can do, you can select all of these layers and make a duplicate by pressing the Ctrl D and place them sideways. Now hold down the Ctrl Alt and Shift keys while reducing the size. That way it will reduce the size simultaneously from all the sides. And now let's see the slideshow. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.